Ibid by H.P. Lovecraft, narrated by Peter Coates. As Ibid says in his famous Lives of the Poets, from a student theme. The erroneous idea that Ibid is the author of the Lives is so frequently met with, even among those pretending to a degree of culture, that it is worth correcting. It should be a matter of general knowledge that C.F. is responsible for this work. Ibid's masterpiece, on the other hand, was the famous op-sit, wherein all the significant undercurrents of Greco-Roman expression were crystallized once and for all, and with admirable acuteness, notwithstanding the surprisingly late date at which Ibid wrote. There is a false report, very commonly reproduced in modern books prior to von Schweinkopf's monumental Geschichte der Ostrogothen in Italien, that Ibid was a Romanized Visigoth in Ataulf's horde who settled in Placentia about 410 AD. The contrary cannot be too strongly emphasized, for von Schweinkopf, and since his time Littlewit and Bête Noire, have shown with irrefutable force that this strikingly isolated figure was a genuine Roman, or at least as genuine a Roman as that degenerate and mongrelized age could produce, of whom one might well say that Gibbon said of Boethius that he was the last whom Cato or Tully could have acknowledged for their countrymen. He was, like Boethius and nearly all the eminent men of his age, of the great Anician family, and traced his genealogy with much exactitude and self-satisfaction to all the heroes of the Republic. His full name, long and pompous according to the custom of an age which had lost the trinomial simplicity of classic Roman nomenclature, is stated by von Schweinkopf to have been Caius Anicius Magnus Furius, Camillus Aemilianus Cornelius Valerius Pompeius Julius Ibidus, though Littlewit rejects Aemilianus and adds Claudius Decius Junianus, whilst Bête Noire differs radically, giving the full name as Magnus Furius Camillus Aurelius Antoninus Flavius Anicius Petronius Valentinianus Aegidus Ibidus. The eminent critic and biographer was born in the year 486, shortly after the extinction of the Roman ruling Gaul by Clovis. Rome and Ravenna are rivals for the honour of his birth, though it is certain that he received his rhetorical and philosophical training in the schools of Athens, the extent of whose suppression by Theodosius a century before is grossly exaggerated by the superficial. In 512, under the benign rule of the Ostrogoth Theodoric, we behold him as a teacher of rhetoric at Rome, and in 516 he held the consulship together with Pompilius, Numantius, Bombastes, Marcellinus, Deodamnatus. Upon the death of Theodoric in 526, Ibidus retired from public life to compose his celebrated work, whose pure Ciceronian style is as remarkable a case of classic atavism as is the verse of Claudius Claudianus, who flourished a century before Ibidus, but he was later recalled to scenes of pomp to act as court rhetorician for Theodatus, nephew of Theodoric. Upon the usurpation of Vitiges, Ibidus fell into disgrace and was for a time imprisoned, but the coming of the Byzantine Roman army under Belisarius soon restored him to liberty and honours. Throughout the siege of Rome he served bravely in the army of the defenders, and afterward followed the eagles of Belisarius to Alba, Porto, and Centum Celi. After the Frankish siege of Milan, Ibidus was chosen to accompany the learned bishop Datius to Greece, and resided with him at Corinth in the year 539. About 541, he removed to Constantinopolis, where he received every mark of imperial favour both from Justinianus and Justinus II. The emperors Tiberius and Maurice did kindly honour to his old age and contributed much to his immortality, especially Maurice, whose delight it was to trace his ancestry to old Rome notwithstanding his birth at Arabiscus in Cappadocia. It was Maurice who, in the poet's 101st year, secured the adoption of his work as a textbook in the schools of the empire, an honour which proved a fatal tax on the aged rhetorician's emotions, since he passed away peacefully at his home near the church of St. Sophia, on the sixth day before the calends of September, AD 587, in the 102nd year of his age. His remains, notwithstanding the troubled state of Italy, were taken to Ravenna for interment.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.